On today's Toy Spot, we're having a look at the Hasbro Marvel Ultimate Spider-Man Web Warriors Ultimate Spider-Man. This is Spot's second figure that we're looking at from the Ultimate Spider-Man Web Warriors, having just looked at the Spider-Man 2099. It's recommended for ages 4 and up, and more aligned, clearly geared more towards a child than maybe an adult collector. It's not to say that an adult collector may not pick these up, but the limited posability could alienate some of the older collectors from picking up really these figures. The back of the package actually at least gives us a read-up. His newfound super strength, wall-crawling abilities, and stunning web blast makes Miles Morales an unstoppable force in the fight against crime. Includes figure. That's all it says, includes figure. To check out more from the folks over at Hasbro, head over to www.hasbro.com/Spider-Man. Spot's going to take a break and get this opened up. When we come back, though, we're going to get a better look at the Ultimate Spider-Man Web Warriors Ultimate Spider-Man figure. There's more heading your way. Don't go anywhere. Now that we have the Ultimate Spider-Man out of packaging, yes, he doesn't come with any sort of accessories to speak of. Basically, what you see is what you get here. Although I have to admit that Miles Morales Spider-Man looks pretty good. And it's actually a different sculpt altogether. I thought it was the same mold as the Spider-Man 2099 that we already had a look at. But as you can see, side by side, Ultimate Spider-Man is quite a bit smaller than that of the Spider-Man 2099. So it's not actually the same mold. I did not realize actually he was this small. But that's what it is. It's still limited, unfortunately, if you look at the Spider-Man 29 and now the Ultimate Spider-Man. Yes, posability is very limited. A wiggle back and forth. Did I say wiggle? A swivel back and forth. It could probably still wiggle back and forth. A swivel all the way around in the arms. And actually, he does also have a ball joint head, which is actually something that this guy right here, I'm talking to you, this guy right here actually did have as well. Though his head just didn't tip up and down as much, almost where I then perceived it, where he just had a movement back and forth. But he does actually have a ball joint as well. I do like this figure. The Ultimate Spider-Man works also very well, but I just wish that they would have come with some accessories. Even if these are catered towards the younger boys and or girls, a younger boy and girl would still appreciate some accessories. A Spider-Man is cool, sure, why not? But why not incorporate a firing missile? Oh, ahaha moment there. Firing missiles or a shield, something that they could have clamped onto the side of their arms would have gone a long way. Just gives it a little bit extra more playability, and kids love playability options. Now, as for the figure itself, it does look like the webbing is a little messy, but actually looking at the web is pretty clean. I think it's just the fact that because it's red on black, it looks like there's probably going to be a lot of QC issues, quality control issues, where the paint isn't applied the greatest. But actually, it's quite the opposite. The paint's pretty good. For some strange reason, again, I don't know why their colorings are so off, but the coloring on his shoulders is a different red that's in the front of his chest. Completely different reds. A little bit lighter on the sides. And it's actually when you notice more so on the back how the side reds are completely different than the darker red that's in the middle. It's a very small point to note. It's certainly not the glaring red difference that's on 2099's Spider-Man, which is pretty noticeable. Again, I'm really surprised, though, that the figures are so differently sized. I really did think that they were going to be the exact same size figure, but goes to show, Spot had no idea what he was talking about. Today's Toy Spot, though, we were having a look. This was the Spider-Man Ultimate Web Warriors. Yeah, it was. This was the Ultimate Spider-Man. Not a bad figure. I mean, certainly additional posability, ball joining in the head. Ball joints could easily have gone on any one of the other four limbs, too. The arms and the legs, just giving you some extra posability. Kids love toys, kids love Spider-Man, but kids also like posable Spider-Man too. I wish that Hasbro would give them some additional posability as well. At any rate, today though, we were having a look at the Ultimate Spider-Man. Certainly stay tuned. Spot's gonna have more videos heading your way. As always, thanks for watching. See you next time.